Thanks. There's a bullseye there.
Yes, too much for me.
Keep it for next time. I'll give you a call. You let me in again, yeah?
Yeah, no problem, mate.
Yeah, baby. Here we go. Trellick Tower, done that a few times. The new Wembley Stadium, done that one. Knightsbridge Guards Barracks. Battersea Power Station. Crystal Palace antenna. You can even see the Millennium Dome in the far distance. Quite often, if I'm up on a roof and the builder's up there with me, I'll say, see that? I've jumped that. See that? I've jumped that. And I become really boring and they say, shut up. Get on with the roof.
By night, Dan Wichels is Britain's most prolific base jumper. By day, he runs his own roofing business.
Puts me out of trouble, I suppose, doesn't it? Could be worse. I couldn't be stuck in an office, that's one thing. The base jumping gives me enough excitement to carry on with this, really. I mean, too many people, they just get on a treadmill, don't they? And they go to work, come home, go to work, come home. They turn around, they're 40, then they're 50, 60, retired, and they're dead. Everyone dies, don't they? But not everyone lives. When I meet other jumpers around the world, they say, oh, you jump off the roofs, you work on. I say, well, not yet, but I will one day.
So you don't fancy this one?
This one? This could be a record, this one. She's the Viking. Come on.
No, I'm not.
Dan lives in Essex with his Danish girlfriend, Tia.
You would if you love me.
I don't.
What's it like living with a base jumper?
Well, you do get used to it. At first, I found it really difficult when he was sneaking out during the night. I couldn't sleep at all.
Did you lie awake at night worried?
I did at first.
I apologise for that. No, I do apologise. Obviously, I don't intend to make you suffer or worry you.
I would say lately, because it's been so much the last few years, I'm a bit more used to it now. I don't really like it. I don't, but it's...
You tolerate it, then?
I do, yeah.
Tolerate me?
Yeah, I have to.
Dan met Tia skydiving, but she's never been tempted to try a base jump.
I would like her to do one jump, just to experience in some small way what I get out of it, you know? Just standing on the edge, looking down, thinking,
yeah, no.
I'm gonna die.
Is that what you're thinking?
Every time.
Is it?
Every time.
Really? I didn't know that.
Well, not every time, but sometimes.
Hmm. So do you find that quite shocking to you?
I do, yeah, I do. I think that's maybe a bit over the top.
Well, no, sometimes I think this could be the one, you know, sometimes.
So is it worth it?
Well, obviously it is.
Later that evening, Dan gets ready for a night on the town. The calm weather is perfect for jumping. Dan's determined to make the most of it.
The best all night I've ever done is 5 in the night, which was pretty awesome. If you can do 2 in a night, that's good. 3 is excellent.
Dan's first base jump was 10 years ago, Since then, he's made over 800. Base jumpers are a secretive underground community that like to play while the city sleeps.
Let's go and have a look, eh?
Tonight, Dan's in the London Docklands to attempt to jump from one of the city's tallest skyscrapers. It's one of the most heavily guarded areas in the country, so Dan's in disguise.
Tell me about the outfit, Dan. I'm a security guard, isn't I? Eh? I'm supposed to be here. Eh? Don't want any trespassers on my site. This is landing area A.
Don't you ever think to yourself,
I should be in bed asleep? Yeah, all the time.
So what is it, Liv, Dan?
I don't know, actually. There's obviously some sort of deep emotional problem going on there. Very serious. Shall we?
Base jumping is not a criminal offence, but if caught, Dan's likely to be arrested for trespass or reckless endangerment. For Dan, this only adds to the excitement.
It's the whole experience, you know, it's not just the actual jump itself, it's everything leading up to the jump. You're thinking about it all day and you're planning it, you're going through it in your head. What could go wrong? Will I be smashed to pieces? Will I be dead? Okay, what a beautiful morning. Canary Wharf.
At the top, Dan prepares himself for this 450-foot jump.
It's a scary thing, you know, I mean, especially at night, standing on the edge of something. Could be the last thing you ever do, you know. You look down and you think, what am I doing here? I must be crazy.
Base is the deadliest of all adrenaline sports. With a 1-in-6 death rate, Dan is playing Russian roulette with his life.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Down.
Even when the parachute opens, there's no margin for error. A wrong turn or a gust of wind could smash Dan against the buildings or onto the road.
That was fucking awesome, mate. Everything was perfect. Everything was perfect. All right, let's do the off-ski before we get caught.
Cheating death gives Dan the ultimate high and keeps him coming back for more. But he believes he has everything under control.
I like it a lot. I wouldn't say I'm addicted. I do like it a lot.
So you could give it up then?
I will give it up. I'm not sure when. Hopefully at the right time.
That's the problem, though.
That is the problem.
Isn't it?
That is the problem, yeah.
When?
Yeah, getting out before it gets you. Sooner or later, it's going to bite me back.
In the middle of the night, Dan Wichels loves nothing more than to roam the streets of London, searching for tall buildings to jump from. And he's not alone. 6 years ago, he met a kindred spirit, Ian Richardson. They've been jumping together ever since.
Swing in here, let's go get out and have a look. Dan is, he's a natural base jumper, I'm not. I haven't got the head for heights, I haven't got the physique, and I probably think too much as well.
Ian? He does love it. He loves it probably more than any jumper I've ever met, I think. He loves just going out, you know, wrecking objects, buildings, antennas, anything. It's everything to do with base jumping, he loves.
Base jumpers like to have a partner. A second opinion may be the difference between life and death.
You share incredibly intense moments. Things that you usually don't experience in normal friendships. The only person who really understands it is the person who was there with you to experience it. I think that's what makes it incredibly special.
They've become the most notorious double act in the UK-based community, specialising in bandit jumping.
See ya. Kicking like a good one.
The nocturnal, urban, and most extreme form of the sport. Only a handful of jumpers in the UK have the guts or inclination to try it.
Yes, good boy.
Did you see me?
Get the fuck out of here.
I'm going to kill that pilot. We're nowhere near the drop zone, are we?
No, you're not.
Here I am. On the top of centre point.
3, 2, 1. See ya.
Over the last 6 years, Dan and Ian have used ingenuity, nerve, and skill to jump from some of London's most famous buildings.
You just don't jump Nelson's Column and get away with it. Well, we did.
Here we are, going up Nelson's Column.
3 years ago, they navigated past motion sensors to climb the scaffolding around the 170-foot statue.
Hello, fella.
It is Admiral.
Lord Admiral.
Nelson.
Well, I see no ships.
Fucking red light's going to give us away.
I'd pretty much resigned myself to the fact we was going to get caught up. So I'd already given myself the day off work the next day to help the police with their inquiries.
Three, two, one, see ya.
When the parachutes opened, their cover was blown.
First fare, eh?
No, you shouldn't be doing
that. No. Okay.
As the security guards closed in, the pair tried to escape.
Fucking hell! Just jumped Nelson's car, and looks like we got away with it. Holy shit!
Wembley, another classic.
That year, Dan and Ian also targeted the newly completed home of football. Amazingly, they bowled straight in.
Plan as much as you want, but you need a bit of luck on the day, and on that particular day, we're very lucky.
3, 2, 1, see ya. Oh my God, he shoots his gun. They think it's all over.
Nice back in work.
Unbelievable.
You're only limited by your imagination and, to a degree, by how high or low you're willing to jump.
At the Millennium Dome, the worry was that the jump was too low and there wouldn't be enough time to open the parachute and slow down the fall. Normally, Dan and Ian won't consider any jump under 150 feet. Ian decided not to jump, worried that his body wouldn't withstand the impact. But Dan wanted to risk it.
Dan's lighter than me, smaller than me. He's more experienced than me, he's better skilled than me, he's luckier than me.
Dude, I have a fucking good one, man.
I have to know when to kind of not follow him, because then you do become like the lemming, where you just basically, oh, Dan's going, I'm going to go as well.
Have a good one, dude.
And that's dangerous.
OK, here we go. 3, 2, 1, see ya.
Thank you very much.
Nice one, fella.
I don't agree that he should have done the jump, and yes, he walked away from it, but I think he could easily have broken his legs on that jump. Easily have broken his legs on that jump.
You know.
That sums up Dan in some respects. He seems to know how to dodge bullets, because he's dodged a lot of them.
Dan has been jumping for 10 years and managed to avoid serious injury so far.
If possible, every pack job's identical. They seem to work, so why change it? What you don't want is what we call a 180. It opens 180 degrees facing what you've just jumped from, which is probably your worst nightmare, apart from the parachute not opening, of course.
But not all base jumpers have been as fortunate as Dan. His first jump buddy and best friend, Neil Kemeny, was killed 6 years ago.
Me and Neil started together, Same time. As good as gold, wasn't he? One of the boys. Very intelligent, sensible. Just like me, really.
In the UK, there are approximately 30 active base jumpers. Since the sport started, at least 15 Brits have been killed.
This is the base fatality list. I think we're around like 140, 150 fatalities since 1981. It's actually a very useful and relevant tool in base jumping because hopefully people can learn from other people's mistakes. Should really put them all in frames and hang them up.
Many others have been killed in base-related accidents. Neil died when climbing to a jump site.
So, you know, it was quite a difficult time when he died. So.
You were close, weren't you?
Yeah, very close, yeah. Very.
I mean, could you talk about how it affected you?
Not really.
That's
it. I'm not going to talk about how it affected me, no.
A few months after Neil's death, Dan formed a new partnership with Ian. And through base, they've travelled the world together. As two of Britain's best, they're often invited to enter competitions in countries where the sport is more accepted. However, 2 years ago in Benidorm, Ian made a jump that didn't go to plan.
10 seconds.
10 second call for Ian Richardson, number 14. 10 second call.
3, 2, 1. See ya.
Ian's parachute opened facing the wrong way, slamming him into the building. His legs snapped, but he landed on a roof that cushioned his fall and saved his life.
Please, don't look at it, Ian. Don't look at it.
Oh, and what have we here?
I wonder who that could be. Let's go and have a look here. Yeah.
Fuck me, it's the hippo. What are you doing here? Eh?
Can you try to move the toes on the left?
Move the finger of the feet.
Yeah, just a scratch.
He said, oh, can you call Nikki? Nikki's his wife. I said, well, yeah, I can, but don't you think it'd be better coming from you? He said, do it from my phone. I said, all right, so I'll do that. So I phoned her. I said, oh, no, it's not Ian, it's Dan. So straight away she's gone, whoop. She said, oh, what's he done? I said, oh, no, it's all right. He's just fallen over again. It's not too bad. She said, if it's not too bad, why isn't he phoning me? Yeah, well, you know, they're just fixing him up. You know, he's got him on some painkillers. You know, he'll give you a call later when he's ready.
This was Ian's worst accident. And for the first time, he seriously considered quitting base jumping.
Having a lot of broken bones is a good incentive behind you thinking, I think time to quit. When the costal bones start to heal, you maybe do start to forget the pain that you were in, and you start to think, well, wasn't too bad, was it? And it can't have been that bad, can it? I don't know.
Easy champ.
8 months after the Benidorm accident, Ian is still too injured to jump. But he can't resist accompanying Dan.
Quite a serious old break, wasn't it, Dan? I think Dan actually was sick.
I missed a couple of jumps, didn't I? That's why I was sick.
We put you off.
Not enough that I don't feel that I want to call it a day. This puts me off. Knowing that I'm coming back to this.
Oh, you miss him.
Oh,
tell me you don't miss him.
You know I'm not going to answer that. But yeah, it does.
You miss him,
it,
really.
It makes it a lot scarier. But I we'll see how it goes.
Did you miss space jumping?
Yeah, a lot. Yeah, I do, big time. But No, it's, I mean, no, no, no. It's just one of those things.
Bit of a limp going on there, geezer.
Whilst grounded, Ian has been reflecting on why bass has such a hook in him.
I don't fully understand what it is that keeps pulling me into this thing that scares me. There's obviously a draw. I'm not a big believer that it's this adrenaline thing. I think that's just a very simplistic way of explaining something that's quite complex. Once you've base jumped, once you've done something like this, and that makes everything else in life seem a little bit easy to deal with. Base jumping is different to anything, and I don't see what's going to replace that. So in that respect, I kind of regret ever getting into something that I can't replace.
Have you jumped this weekend then?
About 4:30 this morning.
On your own, of course?
Yeah. What do you mean, of course? You're saying I've got no friends.
Well, what other loony...
No, but they're dying, aren't they? That's what's happening to your friends.
What other loony would be out at 4:30 on a Sunday morning?
But you used to always take someone with you. You always said you'd never do it on your own.
Yeah, but they...
In case you splashed on the floor.
They keep disappearing on me, don't they?
Yeah.
So what do you think of Dan's jumping?
I think it's very brave, foolhardy, and I wish he'd back it up. But I do admire the courage that goes with it, because it must do, mustn't it? It's frightened the life out of me.
Well, obviously, it's on your mind all the time, isn't it? If I was his girlfriend, it would be even worse, wouldn't it? But I don't know. We don't know when he's doing it, do we? We don't know, we don't ask. But she knows.
Well, would you rather know or rather not know?
I'd rather not know.
Oh, that's all right then. I won't tell you.
I'd rather you check it in myself. Retired undefeated, yeah. That's the thing to me.
Well, I mean, wouldn't you rather stay in bed?
Yeah, nice and warm in bed.
When the alarm goes off, I think, shall I get up? And it's cold and icy. But if I do get up and I do go out and do the jump, then I'm glad.
Why?
Because I am.
But why?
Well, it's what I do, isn't it?
Yeah, but you've done it.
Well, I'll do it again.
Do you feel afterwards you're on a high?
Yeah, this is
a little bit, yeah. You do, yeah.
A little bit?
Yeah.
To get up at 4:00 in the bleeding morning and go and jump off a building, I've got more than a little high from it, I think.
Yeah. When you've asked him to give up, does he just ignore you then, or
yes.
What? He could have.
Yeah.
Now, what he does is he yeses you to death, and then carries on and does exactly what he wants anyway. Yeah, you understand what I'm saying?
Despite his family's concerns, Dan's soon back out hunting for new opportunities. Today he's aiming to add the Barbican Centre to his long list of conquered London landmarks.
So what's the plan, Dan?
The plan is to get in that building, get on the roof and jump it. That's the plan.
So how are you going to do it?
I'm not sure if I can tell you, really.
Really?
No, not really. Well, you got to play your cards close to your chest, didn't you? Looks the part, eh? That is a base jumper's dream, looking up at something like that.
For every successful jump, there are many failures.
I was sure this was going to get us in.
Dan doesn't like to be beaten, and the following week, he's back.
Let's come up with a plan B. Plan B for Barbican. Well, all of the Barbican buildings are smart apartment blocks. So, got to dress accordingly, really. So I'm going to try and follow a resident in as they come out.
Barbican. Let's have it. 3, 2, 1, 2. Yeah, base jumping, baby. What a fucking blinding result.
Dan's appetite for base is insatiable, and he's about to take even greater risks in his chase for thrills. With Ian out of action, Dan has found a new jump buddy, Julian from Blackpool.
Doing a left and right.
Essex boy, isn't he? Outgoing. Yeah, good lad, you know. Good fun, good crack to jump with.
It's all flooded up here.
Dan, you know, there's a jump on, he's up for it, which is, you know, worth driving for.
Julian is the hippo's replacement, and the hippo is Neil's replacement. I'll have to line up Julian's replacement soon.
Tonight, Dan and Julian aim to jump from the roof of the Hilton, one of London's most famous hotels.
You're a bit early, mate. I'm back in about 5 hours.
Security is tight, so Dan has asked Ian along to help devise a cunning plan.
We'll soon find out if it's a goer. If not, then we need to come up with some plan Bs. I say we. Like I said, I'm here for the minibar.
This has been jumped very few times, very few. 20 odd years ago, geezer died here, hit the building, got his arm ripped off on a balcony, ended up going through the glass roof over the porch.
Right at the very top of the stairwell, there's a bit of scaffolding, and there's like a hatch at the top.
They've booked a room and discovered a way out onto the roof. Now they must wait until the early hours of the morning.
Yeah, so I think it should be on. I think it should be on, yeah.
You've got your fishing wire.
If you go through that tarp and you find that you're not able to get the roof, you'll wish you had some.
Get your tarp past 12, we're in Park Lane. We need some fishing wire.
For Ian, it's the subterfuge that's so exciting.
I'm glad you're here.
I love the homework. You decide what you want to jump. You decide if it's possible, if it's jumpable, if there's a landing area, how you're going to infiltrate it, how you're going to get past security, how you're going to get to the top. I love that. I absolutely love that. I get such a kick out of that.
Cam, we're going to be making a move pretty soon.
I'm ready.
That's what it's all about.
It's 5 a.m. Leaving the injured Ian behind, Dan and Julian head for the roof, 330 feet above Park Lane.
Should we get this one down? A little bit simple.
It's as close as you can get to being a master criminal without committing any major crimes.
Yep. That route, champ.
You ready?
Yep. Nice. Sweet as. All right, here we go.
Ian's ready with a getaway car and drives them to safety.
Couldn't have gone better, actually. Textbook.
So how are you feeling, Dan?
You know, buzzing. Certain amount of relief. Glad we did it without any incident, but it's worth it.
Right, now get out of my car.
Worth all the aggravation.
Were you said to be watching and not jumping?
A little. A little.
He'll be back.
Aye. What are you going to do? Cry? No. I mean,
Arnold Schwarzenegger, he'll be back. We'll do this again.
Yeah, it'd be nice to be jumping, but we'll see. We'll see.
Dan's relentless pursuit of base is starting to put pressure on his relationship with his girlfriend, Tia.
I do understand that it's a very selfish thing that I do. You know, and it putting her through this all the time is very unfair. But I need to do it. He's a good boy. She does have concerns about our future because obviously it could affect it completely. You know, if something happens, any future we might have planned together, you know, could change in an instant, couldn't it, you know?
So if you had to choose between a tier or base jumping, what would you choose?
You put me on the spot now, haven't you? I'd have to give up base jumping.
Honestly?
Yeah. Yeah. There's no future in base jumping. It can only end one way. If you keep jumping long enough, it's only going to end one way.
And that's what she needs to do, then,
isn't it? Shh. Don't give her ideas. Kimber!
Despite claiming that there's no future in base, Dan's actions tell a different story.
Ta-da! What do you reckon of this one, eh? Is that the bollocks or what? It's my new wingsuit. This allows me to fly forwards as well as going downwards. It's called a wingsuit. So it opens up a whole new world of jumping, almost like flying. Yeah, what could go wrong? I always vowed never to do any wingsuit base jumps because, you know, I got a couple of close friends that died doing it, and several other people I knew died doing it, so obviously I always thought it was going to be a big mistake. But I got to the point I thought, if I never try it, I'll always be curious. So I had to give it a go. I had to, didn't I? Curiosity killed the cat, eh?
A month later, Dan organises a trip to Lauterbrunnen in Switzerland. With 1,000-foot cliffs, it's a base mecca that attracts hundreds of jumpers every year. Dan has invited Ian along, who's just recovered from his broken leg. It's an important trip for them both. Dan has yet to master his new wingsuit, and it's Ian's first jump since his accident. Ian's wife, Nikki, has mixed feelings about his return to base.
I think she is very, very comfortable about me getting back into it, but obviously she just doesn't want me to hurt myself again. But Nikki knows that it means a lot to me. And I think it makes me a better person as well. So, yeah, she's happy about it, but not happy about it at the same time. I mean, I would be the same.
I think she thinks I'm the devil on his shoulder. I'm the devil in a base rig, I think. I think sometimes she wishes I would sort of disappear. Because she's on one shoulder saying, oh yeah, let's go and do husband and wife things and nice meals, and I'm on the other shoulder going, let's go and jump in that building, let's go and do this, let's go and do that, let's go away. It'd be fine.
What could go wrong?
It's not lost on me that it's a selfish thing to do. I understand that. But I don't think life's as simple as that's just selfish and that's unselfish. Is it really that selfish? Do I want to be somebody who doesn't jump but is maybe slightly unsatisfied or unfulfilled or not pushed in life? I don't know.
It's still quite fresh in my mind, you know? All the pain and the kind of getting through what I've been through. So I'm nervous. I don't want to go through it again. This is kind of a full-on jump, so I've got to be on it. I'm hoping it'll all just feel good when I go off.
Do
Are we looking down?
It's clear, but it's raining.
Yeah, I know. A bit shitty, innit?
You wanna go?
Well, let's go and have a look. It's not exactly fun jumping in the rain, is it?
We do have a jump, but we go back.
It's good. I mean, it's scary, but it went well. Let's not kid ourselves. It wasn't ideal today, but I didn't think it was particularly dangerous. But anyway, it went well. Yeah, I'm happy. It's good to get it out of the way. I feel better for having done it.
I'm on the wingsuit, mate. It's all new to me, wingsuiting. Do I look nervous? Okay. There we go. Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Nice, Dan.
Over the week, Dan soon gets to grips with his new wingsuit and can't get enough of it.
3, 2, 1. See you guys!
Lacking in confidence, Ian makes fewer jumps.
Boy, nice one.
The climax of the trip is a jump from the Mushroom. A rocky outcrop 10,000 feet up the north face of the Eiger. With a free fall of over a minute, it's one of the highest base jumps in the world.
I'm actually really happy. Yeah, this is pretty amazing, actually.
Good work, champ.
Thank you, my man.
Special.
That summarised it. It's not your average base jump. It's a very special jump. That was awesome. Helicopter, everything. Scary, but really exciting. Really fun.
It's the end of the trip and time to head home to London. But Dan wants one more jump. And Ian can't resist the temptation to join him.
Right. You okay?
Oh, hang on.
You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. See you, boys.
Final day of their Swiss trip, Dan and Ian can't resist one last leap. Ian's lines are twisted, and he can't control the direction of the parachute.
Hit the ground? What do you mean?
Where is he? Where is he? Show me, where is he?
Down there, in the grass.
On the landing area?
On the ledge?
No, in the forest, in the grass.
Yeah, he's not moving. Not moving? Oh, fuck, man.
After calling the emergency services, Dan immediately sets off to discover what's happened to his jump buddy.
Like we're in a hospital to me. Could be Interlaken. Let's go see who's in this room. And who is this? It's Ian Richardson, world famous base jumper and stuntman. And what was today's little stunt? Hooking into the talus at La Mousse. Not one of your better ones, eh?
Well, I think contextually,
you need a... Contextually? Okay. The truth is, he had line twists, and he managed to avoid a cliff strike and landed quite heavily on the talus, possibly saving his life, or even more serious injury. Injuries sustained are...
Three broken ribs.
Punctured lung.
And quite a fucked up elbow.
Ooh.
Broken.
So here we are in intensive care. Here we go. Welcome to base jumping.
For the second time in a year, Ian has narrowly escaped death. And once again, he's forced to consider quitting.
There's nothing quite like a slap of reality than lying in a hospital bed and you kind of think, what the f- have I just done? I was thinking, why am I putting myself through this? Why am I putting my family through this? Why am I doing this? Felt that that was a good warning, that was as good a sign as I ever would get, that I should walk away.
On returning to London, Ian officially announces his retirement from base jumping on the internet. Dan's thoughts then turn to his own retirement.
Well, that is my biggest concern, what I'm going to do with myself when I'm not jumping anymore. Maybe I'll have some kids. That'll keep me busy, keep me quiet.
Have you honestly given that some real consideration?
What, kids or giving up jumping?
Starting a family.
Yeah, I've thought about it, yeah. I think maybe I should before I forget what to do. It would be a crime if I didn't bring another one like me into the world. The goalposts are moved once you've got other people relying on you, you know. You've got big responsibilities. It's no longer is it all about you.
Do you think you will ever give up?
No. I don't think so.
Seriously?
Yeah, no. He lost it too much. It's his life. If you'll take that away from him, I don't know what will be left. I think the only way he will give up is if you'll get hurt. That's the only way, I'll say.
He's starting to talk about family. Do you think family would change him, having a family?
No. No, definitely not. They're all saying that, but it's just, do you want to risk that? Do you want to stand alone with children while he's jumping out and won't come home one day? So it's, I don't think it will.
So surely that must put you off having kids, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does, definitely. He said to me at first, a base jumper never retires. And it's just like, well, you die or you just keep jumping.
Well, nice of you to show up. Where the devil are you?
Maybe it should be time for him to say, right, that's it, I've done it, it's over. Do I think he will? I don't know. I think it's got him. Base jump, it's got him. I think he needs it. He loves it. Yeah, we'll see, eh? We'll see. Bed with a Viking.
If you were to die base jumping, how would you want people to feel?
Well, maybe just to think that he died doing something that he was passionate about and he loved. It's the best I could hope for, really.
Would you want them to feel sad?
Of course. Just so long as they remembered me, that's all. Looking like it, Dan. This is the one. Let's see what you're made of. Okay. 3, 2, 1.
See ya.